Hello everyone, myself is Dr. Pinkesh Sutaria, working as an assistant professor at Department of Chemistry, Bhavans College, Dakur. So in our previous lecture, we have seen that the rules and regulations for IR spectroscopy examples. Okay, so now in today's lecture, we will be focusing on the examples. Okay, so let us start with the first example. Suppose in examination they will ask like this question, that is C2H3N. Okay, the region, or they can give the IR spectra like this. IR spectra in which we are having 3010 centimeter inverse up to 2950 medium peak. Second one, that is 2255 medium peak and 1370 centimeter inverse. Okay, so these are the IR peak. Okay, so you have to find out what is the structure of this molecular formula. So in first one, in first step, you have to find out what is the DBE of that structure. So the formula for the DBE, that is 2A plus 2 minus B minus D divided by 2. Here A will be the number of carbon atom. So here we are having 2, so we can put over here, that is 2. Okay, here we can also put 2a plus 2 plus minus b minus d. B, that is your number of hydrogen atom, that is 3. D, that is number of nitrogen atom, that is 1. Okay, so you have to put 2a plus 2 minus b minus d divided by 2. So here we can have a 6 minus 2 divided by 2, so that will be the 4 divided by 2, so you can have a 2. Okay, so if we are having 2 dBE value, okay, if we are having 2 dBE value, what we can say, your compound should have at least 2 double bond, okay, that is 2 double bond, or we can have 1 double bond, okay, 1 double bond or 2 ring. Okay, 1 double bond or 2 ring. Okay, one double bond or one ring, one double bond or one ring, or we can say two ring, that should be present in the structure. Okay, so now here we are having 3010 and 2950. Okay, so this is the peak for the, what we can say, that is the aliphatic stretching. Okay, that is alkane aliphatic stretching. So CH3 may be present, so alkane CH3 stretching. Okay, so you have to write down like this, CH3 alkane stretching. Then after, it is the most important peak. Okay, in my previous lectures, I have explained you the chart in which we can have a 2 peak nearly at 2200 up to the 2300. So that is C triple bond C or C triple bond N. So here in this structure, we can see that over here, we can have a nitrogen. If we are not having a nitrogen, we can say that a C triple bond C may be present. But if we are having nitrogen, you can say that C triple bond C stretching may be, sorry, C triple bond N stretching may be present. Okay, so this is the what we can say, the assumption that we have got from the IR spectra. Now in the last one, we are having 1370. Now this 1370, it might be because of the CH bending. Okay, it is because of the CH bending. Okay, now if you can look out this structure, we are getting a CH3 as well as CN. So what we have to do? So here I have to sum up this thing, C2H3 and N, that is my main formula, in which we are getting CH3, second one I am getting CN. If I put over here, that is the sum of over here, we can get a C2 as well as H3, that is N. Okay, so the formula is satisfied. So I can say that my structure of this compound, it is a CH3CN. Okay, so this is my structure, CH3CN. In examination, you have to write down the whole structure like this, CH3 C triple bond N. Then after, you have to also write down the name of that particular compound. You can write down this compound, that is acetonitrile, ओके, और वी कैन राइट डाउन अ कंपाउंड लाइक मिथाइल साइनाइड. ओके, सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ मिथाइल साइनाइड एज वेल एज द एसिटोनाइट्राइल. यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर द टू पीक 3010, 2950 एंड सेकेंड वन दैट इज 2250. ओके, नाउ 3010 दैट इज फॉर द सी एच थ्री स्ट्रेचिंग एंड 2250 दैट इज फॉर द सी थ्री पर बॉन्ड एंड. ओके, बाय सॉल्विंग दिस टॉपिक यू कैन इजिली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. सो दैट इज द एसिटोनाइट्राइल और वी कैन से अ मिथाइल साइनाइड. ओके, रिमेंबर दैट द डेटा शुड बी गिवन यून इन योर एग्जामिनेशन पेपर. सो यू डी नॉट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द डेटा और यू नॉट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द मग ऑफ द डेटा. ओके, एटलीस्ट यू शुड हैव एन आइडिया बाय कैलकुलेटिंग अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 30 to 40 examples, you will have an idea which type of peak should be covered in the particular region. Okay, so now let us understand one more example. So the example, it is like this, the molecular formula. They will give the molecular formula. Okay, the molecular formula that is given, that is C8H10. Okay, so now they are giving as a IR region. So the IR peak, that is 3070, that is 3035, okay, up to the 3035. Second one, that is 2979 and 2880. Okay, third one, that is 1610. Fourth one, that is 1498. Fifth one, that is 1458. Seventh, that is 743. And last one, that is 692. Okay, so these are the data that is given in the what we can say IR spectrum. Okay, so first of all, what we have to do, we have to just calculate the DBE for this compound. So in IR spectroscopy, you just have to calculate first of all DBE, that is 2A plus 2 minus B minus D divided by 2. So here in this region, 2A plus 2 carbon atom, that is 8 into 2, 16, 16 plus 2, 18, minus B minus D, here you are not having any D. So we can put directly 10, 18 minus 10 divided by 2, that is 8 divided by 2, that is having a 4. Okay, so now if you are getting the DBE value for the 4, you can say that you should have a benzene ring. Okay. First of all, you should remember that you should have a benzene ring for the DBE. So after writing a DBE value, you should write like this way, assumption from the DBE. Okay, what is your assumption? That the compound structure or molecular formula should have, okay, you can write down like this way, should have at least one benzene ring. Okay, at least one benzene ring. Okay, then after we have to predict the data, whatever the data that we have given in the example. Let's say, suppose if you are given the data like this, 3070, 3050, then after 2970, 2880, okay, then after 1610, 1498, okay, 1458, 743, 692. Okay, so first thing you have to remember, in from the DBE you can get the idea about the benzene ring. One of the most important thing that you have to remember, that if you are getting a peak nearly about 3050 to the 3100, you should say that the compound should have a aromatic stretching, ARH. Okay, ARH stretching. That is aromatic stretching. One of the most important thing, another, that you have to remember that, and whenever you are having a AR aromatic stretching, you can find out the three important peak, that is nearly about 1400, 1500 and 1600. That is your CC bending. That is your CC bending. Okay, you just have to remember that. If we are having 3050 up to the 3100 and 14, 15 and 1600, that should be your, what we can say, CC bending for the aromatic ring. Okay, that is your CC bending. Now this CC bending, that is C double bond C bending. Okay, in benzene we can have a double bond as well as the single bond. So that will be for the CC double bond bending. Okay, now next thing, that is 2970 up to 2880. That is your aliphatic stretching. Okay, that is your aliphatic stretching. Okay, second thing you have to remember. Now 743 and 692. Okay, I have explained in my previous lecture that if we are getting two peak in the region of 690 up to the 850, you will have a two probability. First one, you can have a mono substitution, and second one, you should have a meta substituent. Okay, so we can write down over here, okay, mono substituent or meta substituent. Mono substituent or meta substituent, that is present in the structure. Okay, so now let us combine this thing. Okay, so in the given formula, you are having a C8 and H10. Okay, you are getting a aliphatic stretching as well as the aromatic stretching. So for the aromatic stretching, you can write down C6H5. For the aliphatic, you can write down a CH3. Okay, now minus this thing, C8 from the C8 minus C6 and 1. So you will get a C. Okay, 5 plus 3, 8, 10 minus 8, that will be CH2. Okay, so your compound structure should be like this, a 6, 6H5, second one that is CH2, and third one that is CH3. So you can write down the structure of this compound, that your compound should have at least one benzene ring, then after CH2 and CH3. Okay, why we are not writing as a meta substituent? Okay, because for the meta substituent, you have to write down like this, CH2, and here we can write down CH3. But as the valency problem, you cannot write down the CH2 like this. Okay, for this mono and meta, one of the important spectroscopy, that is NMR spectroscopy, you have to learn. But in your syllabus, you are not having NMR spectroscopy. So we are only focusing on the IR. So from the IR, we can say that your compound should have a CH2 and CH3. Okay, so the name of this compound, that is ethyl benzene. Okay, ethyl benzene. Okay, so this is the one of the simplest example you can ever come across. So that is ethyl benzene. Okay, now let us understand one more example for the better understanding of the IR spectra. Now let us take one more example, that is formula, that is C1 as a C4, H10 and oxygen. Okay, so first of all, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the DBE for this compound. So that is 2A plus 2 minus B minus D divided by 2. So here in this structure, we can have a 2A plus 2. Okay, so A, that is carbon atom, 4 into 2, 8, 8 plus 2, that is 10 minus 10. Okay, why we have not considered the D? Okay, the D, that is only for the nitrogen atom, or what we can say, trivalent atom. Divalent atom should not be considered. Okay, so 10 minus 10 divided by 2, your DBE will be 0. Okay, if your DBE will be 0, you can say that your compound should have a saturated structure. Okay, what is saturated structure? Okay, the saturated structure, that means that compound should have a single type of double bond or triple bond, or what we can say, single bond. Okay, the compound should have at least one single bond, or all the compound should have, all the bonds should have a single bond or double bond or triple bond. There is only one type of bond present in a structure. That type of compound, it is known as a saturated compound. Okay, so that is our idea. Second thing, the spectra that is given in your examination, that is 2990 up to the 2875. Second one, that is given as 1140 centimeter inverse. So from 2990, we are having, that is CH3. Okay, first thing you write down, that is CH3, that is alkane stretching. Second one, so this is the most important peak that you have to remember, that if we are getting 1050 up to the 1100 or what we can say 1000 centimeter inverse up to the 11000 centimeter inverse. That is the peak for the ether linkage. So here we are getting a 1140. So we can say that the compound should have a ether linkage, that is CO. Okay. Now this CO, that is for the bending. Okay. Okay. So now in the structure that they have given as a C4H10 and oxygen, from this we are getting as a CH3. Second one we are getting CO. Okay. So for CO linkage, or what we can say the O linkage, ether linkage, CH3, that is CH3 and O, that should be minus from the structure, so you can get a C3H7, that we have to arrange. So from the IR spectra we are not getting any particular region. From the NMR we can get more about this structure, but from the IR spectroscopy we have to study. So we have to arrange like this. Suppose CH3, so we can write down the CH3. Now we can also write down the one more CH3 from here. So this is the ether linkage in between that. So from this CH3 and CH3 we can get that CH3 and CH3. Second one, you have to assumption like this. Suppose if I want to rub this thing, second thing you have to remember that you have to write down C2H6 and O. After that you have to write down a C2. C4 minus C2, that is C2. C10 minus H6, that is H4. Now this C2H4 you have to multiply by 2. So you can write down like this CH2 and CH2. That is C2H4. You can evenly divide it this thing. Why I have to do this thing? Because we are getting only 2 peak from the IR. So it is very difficult from the IR to predict the structure. So here we can write down the CH2. Here also we can write down the CH2. Now look at this structure. C4, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. H10, 3 plus 2, 5. 3 plus 2, 5, 10. And oxygen. Second thing you have to remember that suppose in this type of structure if you are getting only one peak from the IR, you have to just divide by the smallest number. So here we are having a C4H10. You can evenly divide it like this C2H5, second one C2H5, and last one, that is oxygen. So this is our method. You need not have to write down this method in your examination, that we have to calculate by your rough work. That is your rough work. You have to predict, you have to assumption the structure should be like this or like that. It is very difficult. Again and again I am repeating that it is very difficult for the any organic chemist to predict the structure on the basis of IR only. In MSc you will have a 1H NMR as well as 13C NMR as well as the mass spectroscopy. By combination of these four spectroscopy you can easily predict. But in your syllabus you are having only IR spectroscopy, so I am trying to make as much easy as I can. So now let us understand the one most example, that is let us take one more example. The example, it is like this. The molecular formula that is given in your example, that is C8H8 and oxygen. First of all let us calculate the dB from the structure. So dB, that is 2A plus 2 minus B minus D divided by 2. 2A plus 2, that is 8 into 2, 16. 16 plus 2, that is 18, minus 8 divided by 2. So that will be the 10 divided by 2, so you can have a 5. If you are getting a dB more than the 4 value, you can say that your compound should have a benzene ring. Your compound should have a benzene ring. One most important thing that you have to remember, that if you are having a benzene ring, then your compound formula should be more than the 6 C6. at least you have a 6 carbon atom, then and then you can say that your compound should have a benzene ring. If you are having a C4, you cannot say the benzene ring should be present. Okay, so simultaneously you have to compare the DB value as well as the molecular formula. Okay, second thing, in your example that is given by the IS spectra, they have given the value, that is 3070 up to the 3010. Second thing, that is 2970, 2860. Third thing, they have given 1685 centimeter inverse, 1605 centimeter inverse. Second one, that is 1485. Okay, third one, that is 14. 1450 centimeter inverse. Third one, that is 758 centimeter inverse, and fifth last one, that is 68 double centimeter inverse. Okay, centimeter inverse that you have to write down for the all the spectra. Okay, now by looking at the structure, okay, first thing you have to remember that the from the DB value you have concluded that a compound should have a benzene ring. Second thing, we have to compare the IR value. The IR value, that is 3010, that is for the aromatic stretching. You just write down this thing, aromatic stretching. Aromatic stretching, you have to remember that up to the 3000 centimeter inverse, up to the 31 centimeter inverse. Okay, second thing, the peak should be in the region of 1400, 1500 and 1600. You can say that is nearly about the 1500. Okay, so now this is for the C double bond C bending. Okay, that is C double bond C bending. Okay, for the aromatic compound. Okay, that you have to write down. Okay, now from the 3070, that is aromatic stretching. Another thing, that is C double bond C, from the 1400, 1500 and 1600. These are the four friends, okay, that can exist in a similar type of nature. Okay. 1400, 1500, 1600 centimeter inverse. Okay, second one, 300, okay, that is 3000 centimeter inverse up to the 31 centimeter inverse. Okay, so that is your aromatic stretching, okay, C double bond C, and aromatic stretching, that is ARCH. Okay, now here we are also getting us 1685, that is a special peak. Okay, above 600 centimeter inverse, if you are getting a 1685 centimeter inverse, that is for the ketonic stretching. Okay, that is for the ketonic stretching. Now for 2970 up to 2860, again we are getting a CH3 alkane stretching. Okay, now this CH3 alkane stretching, okay, ARH, CH3, CO, C double bond C. Now this two peak, okay, that is for the mono substituent or meta substituent. Okay, so the given formula, let us understand by the doing a rough work, that is C8H8 and OO, that is our molecular formula. If we are getting aromatic stretching, we can minus from here, that is 66H5. Second one you can minus from here, that is CH3. Third one you can minus over here, that is CO. Okay, now let us minus from here, C8. 6 plus 2, 8, that is 0. Okay, CH8, that is 5 plus 3, that is 0. Okay, again 0. So you can have the idea that compound should have C6H5, CO as well as the CH3. So you can easily predict the structure that your compound should have this type of structure, that is CO, CH3. Okay, you are having a benzene ring, you are having a ketonic group and CH3. Now this ketonic group you cannot write this way, okay, for the meta substituent. Okay, that is the wrong method, because we are having a fourth valency for the carbon atom here, that is not satisfied, so you can directly omit this structure. Okay, so you can directly say the compound should have this type of structure. Now what is the name of this structure? You can write down, that is acetophenol. Okay, so that is the structure of acetophenone, or you can write down, that is the phenyl methyl ketone also. Okay, that is a phenyl methyl ketone. Okay, so acetophenone, or you can write down the phenyl methyl ketone. So by that way, you can calculate this type of example. Okay, now let us understand one more example. So that is C7H8 and oxygen. Okay, so this is our molecular formula. First thing you have to write down for the DBE for this compound, that is 2A plus 2 minus B minus D divided by 2. Here we are having at A, that is 7 number. Okay, so 7 into 2, 14, 14 plus 2, 16, 16 minus 8 divided by 2, that should be a 4. Okay, if you are getting a 4, then you can say that compound should have a benzene ring. Okay, the compound should have a benzene ring. Okay, I will not write down this thing again and again. In example, you have to write down the assumption from the DBE. Though you can write down from here that the compound should have a benzene ring from the given formula. Okay, now let us understand by its IR spectra. The IR spectra, that is 3065 centimeter inverse, that is 300. They can write down like this: medium, sharp, broader. So they have given here, that is a medium peak. Second one, that is 2950 centimeter up to 2840 centimeter. Again, they have written as a medium peak. Okay, they have written as a medium peak. Okay, next thing they have written as a 1604. Okay, second one, that is 1498. Third one, that is 1397. Okay, last one, that is 1049. Okay, 750 and 688. Okay, so in examination they will be given like this. Okay, whatever the peak they have given, you just have to write down like this whatever I am writing over here. Okay, if you are not writing from the value, your marks should be cut down. Okay, so whatever the frequency they have given, you just have to write down in front of that what is your assumption. Okay, so from the 3065 centimeter inverse up to the 3005, we can write down that should be a aromatic stretching. Okay, if you are writing aromatic stretching, just look at the three peak, that is a 1500 centimeter inverse, 1400 centimeter inverse, and 1600 centimeter inverse. So these three peaks suggested that you should have a C-C-C-C bending. Okay, now this C-C bending, that is for the aromatic bending. Okay, next one, that is 2950 up to 28040, that should be your CH3 alkane stretching. Okay, that is your alkane stretching. Now 104 centimeter inverse, I have already explained in my previous example, that is for the ether linkage. Okay, that is for the ether linkage, CO linkage. Okay, now 750 up to the 600 centimeter inverse, that is for the mono substituent or meta substituent. Okay, now after predicting this structure, you are having this idea that compound should have a benzene ring, second one the CH3 group, and third one, that is a ether linkage. Okay, so what we have to do, we just have to do a rough work, that is C7H8O, second one 66H5, that is from the prediction, that is the benzene ring. Next one we are getting a CH3. Okay, now if I am writing oxygen for the ether linkage, you can say that over here 6 plus 1, 7, 5 plus 3, 8, and oxygen. So you have to just write down the benzene ring over here. Second one, you have to write down oxygen, and that is CH3. Okay, that is the only way you can write down. You cannot write down like this way, that is CH3O. That is the wrong method. You have to write down by like this, OCH3. Now this OCH3, now C6H5. That is from the benzene ring that we have predicted from the DBE as well as the IR spectra. Oxygen, that is for the 1050 up to the 1100 centimeter inverse, and this is for the 2950 centimeter inverse. So by that way you can have a OCH3 group. Now this OCH3, that is known as anisole. Okay, so this is the anisole structure. Okay, so by that way you can calculate this type of example. Okay, so now this is IR spectroscopy's example. I will be giving you one more example for the homework. So you here you can write down for your homework, that is C8H8 oxygen 2. Okay, IR spectroscopy they have given as a 2940 2830 centimeter inverse, second one 2700 centimeter inverse, 1700 centimeter inverse, okay, 1601 centimeter inverse, 1515 centimeter inverse, okay, 1275 centimeter inverse, okay. They have also given like this 834 centimeter inverse. Okay, so what is the structure? You just have to find out by your own. And in our next lecture, we'll be starting from this example. So you have to be ready for this example. Okay, again, I'm repeating that you just have to write down all your data in one page. Whenever you are solving the exam, where you should have the data value. Okay, so if you are practicing these 30 to 40 example, you should have an command over the spectroscopy of IR. Okay, so now let us conclude our lecture for today's lecture. Thank you for watching it.